all mistakes. But some crab motherfucker straight invading my space. It was approximately 8:47 p.m. I was on my way home, coming back from the gym. Yo, my muscles kinda ache, they felt rigid and stiff. But my mind was at ease from this Coltrane rip. Playing loud out of shot, right on Fulton and Troop. Till the Jeep drowned it out with Exhibit and Snoop. As I get closer to the Heezy baby, certain parts of my body started acting crazy. My ears got the twitching and my right hand shook. I had a sudden need for speed, so I decided to book. As I arrived on the block to see a bunch of kids scoping out my building, noticing the door wide open. I jetted up the stairs past signs of forced entry, expecting to see my humble abode strip empty. Yo, hell no. From the front door to the second floor, had me feeling so alone, embarrassed and insecure. My worldly possessions that I cherished and prized flashed in a matter of seconds before my eyes. But not photographic, more like alphanumeric. You know, VCR, TV, laptop, G3, VS, MP, LP, CDs, RL, P&B, N-I-K-E. Not to mention USARC, 3C, to open up in DC for Run-DMC. Gotta be a nightmare, somebody pinch me. But up the stairs I seen my 10-speed GT right where I left it, rather bizarre. Still felt violated, my apartment door was ajar. As I stormed in thinking it's about to be on, the window was wide open, but nothing was gone. As I dashed to the edge, held my head past the ledge, I seen two hooded figures flipping over a fence. They was way beyond capture, so I took a step back so I could figure this shit out, cause it was getting intense. The computer was on, file cabinets wide open, bookshelves was tipped over. They searched, but ain't still. Wait a minute, this picture from my built-in safe was slightly tilted to the side. I was beginning to feel the same tingling in my ears and hands. Everything else in the house was there, so work with me one time. But my instincts failed me not, the safe was blown wide open and stolen my priceless book of rhymes. So hell no. Elizabeth, this is the big one. Well, fuck it. These niggas got me pulling out my big gun. So be it. They want it, they got it, but can't have it.
Dag nabbit.
The last thing I needed was static. But I got a briefcase for just such an occasion. So I grabbed it, jetted downstairs, hailed a cab. I knew this shit was gonna happen. I was getting too nice. From the briefcase, I pulled out a homing device. 3 times better than LoJack. These MCs are so whack, but now they got a resort stealing my text. As I fixed on their position for my intercept mission, the cabbie was feather footed. It was getting me vexed. As we headed towards Jersey, the signal got strong. Even in the tunnel, I was right on their tail. A green Volkswagen had the nerve to blast bragging. A dead giveaway, now watch justice prevail. I told the cabbie get closer, but he had no heart. Next thing I know, we was like 5 blocks apart. But they was headed for the airport, the getaway plan. Traffic was getting thick, so I got out and ran. Followed the signal all the way to this private hangar. These niggas wanna rendezvous with a Learjet. I drove a luggage car to block the runway. To no avail, they pulled out just in time. But I'm not done yet, now watch this. If I can't have it, no one can.